Oh, hello. My name is Mara, and welcome to Books Like Woe. So, in honor of the fact that recently I read a book that I really wanted to do a Readalike comparison for, but I can't because it would be a spoiler, which was The 10th Girl by Sara Faring. So I would really love to tell you a couple of books that that book reminds me of, but I can't because it would ruin the book. But it made me remember that I really wanted to go ahead and do the good old, if you like this, try this tag/video idea here on BookTube. Now, if you go to a librarian or a bookseller, they will call that a Readalike title. So essentially it's something that librarians and booksellers use to try to hand sell or hand persuade people to try a book. So hey, if you really like this book, you should definitely try this one because these are the things that they have in common. And I have a lot of recommendations like that. So yeah, this is my version of that kind of video. So let's just dive on in. I'm not gonna go in any particular order. I'm just gonna grab pairs of books and start talking about them. Okay, so let's start with probably my favorite book of the year so far, which is All Systems Red by Martha Wells. If you like All Systems Red by Martha Wells, you should read The Kingdom by Jess Rothenberg. I say that because both of these books are very thematically similar in terms of reckoning with ideas of what it means to be human. So in All Systems Red, Murderbot is a human hybrid robot, warrior robot, basically security robot. I think it's a sec unit that calls itself Murderbot, and I just absolutely love it. And it has hacked its governor so that it has a degree of agency and sentience unto itself. And it starts making its own moral choices. There's also sort of a thriller aspect of this book. And then similarly in The Kingdom, the setup is that, so I should mention that this is YA, this is adult, but I think this reads as sort of older YA. So in this version of reality, there is something very similar to Disney World, but the princesses that populate it are human robot hybrids. I can't remember if these actually have any organic human material or if they're just super realistic robots, but same basic idea. There's also a murder mystery plot in this one, and both of these are really reckoning with ideas of what it means to be human. So I would say if you liked this one, this would be a good YA read-alike title for it. Next is one that you've heard me mention often on this channel. So if you like Kate Daniels, which the first book is Magic Bites, then you should read the Sixth World series by Rebecca Roanhorse, the first book of which is Trail of Lightning. Both of these are urban fantasies, and both of these are showcasing genuinely strong, interesting, smart, dynamic female leads. This doesn't have the kind of kick-ass heroine trope that I get kind of sick of, where the female character is very physically tough and is sort of gruff and basically, I don't know, I think a lot of times kind of reads like a man's, it's sort of like a manic pixie dream girl, but tough girl version sometimes I find. And these are two exceptions to that, where I find that the kick-ass heroine at the center of these are really exciting to read about, actual people, flawed, and both of these are people who kind of think themselves beyond loving. And a huge part of the sort of character work in these series is them forming a community around them that kind of shows them that just because they have a dark side, it doesn't mean that they're beyond love or human connection. So the magic systems in both of these are rad. These are both really well written. This is funnier, I think, than this, but this does have some dark humor to it. Yeah. If you've been into Kate Daniels, you should try this, or since this has been a hot series in the last couple years, if you are liking this, I would definitely recommend going back and giving Kate Daniels a try. So a hot new title this year is Well Met by Jen DeLuca. So this has been a very hyped romance for a lot of people this year, definitely deservedly so. I read this, I think, back in June and really enjoyed it. I'm very excited for people to get to read it in September, but it's been very kind of hot. And this is a slow burn romance that has a strong nerdy element with a Ren Faire. So the Readalike title I picked for it was Neanderthal Seeks Human by Penny Reid. The heroine in this is, I think she's basically, you're kind of meant to think on the spectrum, but she's accounting nerd basically. And it's also a slow burn romance. So I think that has that in common. Both of these are very bingeable kind of books. And if you end up liking Penny Reid, she's got a whole series of these for you to enjoy. And most of the time there's some sort of nerdy element in these books. There's a lot of women in STEM. And yeah, so anyway, I think that if you're liking this hot new slow burn romance, give this one a try. Okay, a nonfiction choice would be, last year there was a really hot book called All the Rage by Rebecca Traister, and it was sort of a history of like how women's anger has been able to move forward political movements in the U.S. over history. It was really good, and again, I think just based on when it was released, quite timely. And I think a good Readalike title for it would be Trainwreck by Sady Doyle. Now, this is less political and more of a pop culture analysis, but the underlying kind of premise of this is the women we love to hate, mock, fear, and why. And basically it's about women who sort of like make public spectacles of themselves and sort of how that reflects our society. So I think both of them have a lot to do with like female anger or women not behaving the way that like they're supposed to, or like how feminineness works, and kind of looking at having sort of a historical approach to that that brings it into the present. So I think that if you liked All the Rage by Rebecca Traister, maybe a less obvious Readalike title for it, I think, is Trainwreck. Another one you've heard me talking a lot about this year is Middlegame by Seanan McGuire. Was a very big adult fantasy release, and it had a lot to do with sort of humans becoming gods, or kind of alchemy type science, and this kind of idea of humans, God, magic, our world, people trying to sort of like dominate our world through that. And the Readalike title to me is The Library at Mount Char. I think that this is a much better version of that kind of plot. The other one that I've heard is similar is American Gods by Neil Gaiman. I haven't read that one yet, so I can't speak to that. This to me is a much better version of that kind of book. I also like how this one really, both of them, I think what is an interesting play is kind of straddling the line between sci-fi and fantasy, because you're never totally sure if it's purely magic or if it's just advanced science. Like, I think there's a lot of that. Both of them are quite brutal and graphic. I think this one probably even more so. And again, I just think that this one is the better book. And so if you liked Middlegame, I would definitely recommend you go check out The Library at Mount Char by Scott Hawkins. So next is two books that I think are thematically almost identical. One is YA, one is adult. So the YA is A Heart and a Body in the World by Deb Caletti. This came out last year and I think got at least a little bit of hype to it, but I would say How to Be Safe by Tom McAllister is a very close parallel to it. Both of these are about misogyny and violence, and gun violence in particular, which sadly here in the US becomes a more and more relevant topic pretty much weekly. So I think if you liked this, this is a much like kind of more gallows humor, bitingly satirical take, and it is definitely more like adult literary fiction, whereas this is YA literary fiction. This is a more like make you cry kind of book. This is a more like make you cringe and think kind of book, but theme wise these are very, very similar. Okay, back to nonfiction. So I think if you liked Between the World and Me, I would say I would recommend Eloquent Rage by Brittney Cooper. I think this is a lot about the Black Lives Matter movement in the context of kind of the Black male experience, and kind of contemplating the imminent threat of violence in that capacity that Black men face on a day-to-day basis. Whereas this is much more about the Black female experience and sort of really digs into intersectionality, I think, in a really compelling way, and kind of talking about how Black women face essentially like double discrimination and a lot of internal tensions on wanting to support the Black community, sometimes at the expense of their identity as women, and wanting to support, you know, women and female progress, and not having your identity as a Black woman validated. This one is more pop culture referential, and I actually probably prefer this book to this one, but I think that if you liked the kind of the project of this book, you would enjoy this as well. Both super well-written, some of the best sort of like Black memoir, personal essay type books that have come out of the last few years, in my opinion. Okay, so I've got kind of a three-way recommendation here real quick. So we will go, and these are all high fantasy. So first we'll go, if you liked The Poppy Wars, I think you would probably like The Wolf and the Whale. And that is because both of these are alternative, like our fantasy worlds built on unusual cultures, at least in like the Western fantasy tradition. Like, they're not just your basic bitch medieval fantasy alt take on a world. This is based essentially on China during the 19th century, and this is a mashup of Inuit and Viking culture. The other reason, so like, I think that if you liked that part of the Poppy War you know, having like non-Western basis for the culture, I think you would also like this. The other thing is that I think both of these feature female leads who are really challenging sort of like gender conventions, or like very interesting in terms of sort of their portrayal of their gender. And this one, the main character uses she, her pronouns, but is actually like essentially raised to be gender non-binary or gender fluid. And in this one, you know, she kind of makes some pretty hardcore choices about like how to kind of take control of her body and sort of her gender representation. So I think that in terms of, there's definitely some shared kind of thematic and like world building elements between these two, which is why I'd say if you like this, this is definitely worth your while. And then also, I would say if you liked The Poppy War, you should try Red Sister by Mark Lawrence. And this is mostly because I think thematically, both of these books are very much about female rage. Like that is a huge element, I think, of both of these books. And both of them feature hyper competent, badass fantasy women. So I just think that if you liked, they're also both trilogies. Like they're the same kind of commitment level in terms of the amount of series you have to go. And I think that they're both, this is darker, but these are both pretty dark books in terms of sort of their portrayal of the human condition. So I think if you like this, you'd probably like this and vice versa. Okay, next up, I've got another three-way recommendation. So first of all, if you like Bad Blood by John Carreyrou, which is about the scandal of Theranos, I think you would also probably like The Smartest Guys in the Room. I can't remember that author's name. I want to say it's Beth something, but I'll have the cover up here somewhere. Because both of these are about two of the biggest corporate scandals that have happened in the last, let's say, like 20 to 30 years here in the US. So if you like that piece of Bad Blood of sort of like uncovering rottenness at the core of a business, I think that, you know, if you enjoyed the craziness that was Theranos, you would also enjoy the craziness of what was going on at Enron. And then also I would say that if part of what you enjoyed about Bad Blood is the sort of investigative reportage piece of this at the end where John Carreyrou comes in and is sort of a character, I would definitely recommend All the President's Men, because to me that is like the definitive example of like the investigators kind of being a part, like the part of the story being about getting the story. I think that that's like one of the definitive versions of that. So if you liked Bad Blood, I would also recommend trying All the President's Men, which is probably a top 10 favorite book. Okay, another Ilona Andrews moment. So I would say that if you liked the Hidden Legacy series from Ilona Andrews, I think that you like a romancy enough version of urban fantasy / paranormal romance to enjoy the Psy-Changeling series from Nalini Singh. This is, you know, it should be noted, this is currently a trilogy, just starting a second trilogy. So it is a smaller commitment versus this is book, I think, number 17 or 18 in that series. So this is a longer running series. But I think that both of these have a lot of really interesting political machinations happening. Another difference I should note is that these, you know, individual trilogies are following one couple versus there's a new couple in each of these. But I think that there's a lot of, if what you value is like interesting world building with compelling characters in that kind of paranormal romance / urban fantasy space, I think that if you liked this, the logical next step is to try Psy-Changeling. Or you could try the Guild Hunter series, I guess, from Nalini Singh as well. I'm not as into that one. I personally much prefer Psy-Changeling. Okay, next, another nonfiction one that is kind of based on different types of nonfiction, which made no sense. Let me tell you what I mean. So I'm gonna say that if you liked I'll Be Gone in the Dark by Michelle McNamara, I think you would also like No Visible Bruises by Rachel Louise Snyder. And that is because I think both of these are sort of nonfiction genre blends or mashups that are not typically seen. So this is basically a true crime combined with memoir. And I would say that this is true crime combined with like sociological reportage and a splash of memoir. Basically, neither of these are straightforwardly one type of nonfiction. And I think both of these, the writing is super nice. Both of these handle their subject matter really well. Both of these are very, very dark. So this is about a serial killer who was a rapist and a murderer in the 70s. This is about intimate partner violence / domestic abuse, very dark topics, and a kind of a genre blendy thing in nonfiction. So that's why I think if you like this one, this might be another one to explore in terms of sort of a different type of nonfiction, not the kind of nonfiction you get every day, basically. Okay. And then a fiction one. So I think if you like the Shades of London series from Victoria Schwab, I would recommend trying the Iron Seas. Is that what it is? Yeah, the Iron Seas series from Mel Jean Brooke. So the reason I pick both of these is that I think one thing that people really like in the Darker Shades of Magic, two things, I guess, that people really like in the Darker Shades of Magic series is one, kind of an alternative version of our world with magic. And two, I do think that a lot of people are invested in the various like romantic elements of A Darker Shade of Magic, just based on some of the fan art I see floating around out there. And this is a steampunk alternative history romance series, and each book has a different couple that it follows, but this is a super interesting interpretation, I think, of alternative history, where basically the Mongol Empire like kind of took over the world, and there was a zombie breakout apocalypse thing, and because of that the world looks very different. It is steampunky, so like it's more, you know, dirigibles and things like that, different types of technology, but anyway, so I think that this is a super well done series, and I think some of the same kind of vibes in terms of our world but different, but with magic, I think it would satisfy some of those itches, and it has much better versions of romance in it, in my opinion. Okay, and then my last nonfiction one is that if you liked We Should All Be Feminists by Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie, I definitely recommend trying Our Women Human by Dorothy Sayers. Both of these are very small books. I mean, We Should All Be Feminists was started basically as a speech, and this is equally short. This is, to me, sort of like the OG version of the type of book that We Should All Be Feminists is, which is a very short, concise argument for women's equality kind of in a post-suffrage world, and I think this was life-changing to me. So anyway, if you're interested in feminist literature and interested in going back to some like older feminist literature, I totally recommend this. I always say the spoiler on this is that yes, women are indeed human, and that's kind of what she's arguing for, is women are allowed to be good and bad at the same things that men are, just because we're all people. Okay, so one last romance one is The Kiss Quotient. So if you enjoyed The Kiss Quotient by Helen Huang, and part of what you enjoyed about that was the sex worker and client trope that's happening in this one, I definitely recommend Escorted by Claire Kent, which is, before this came out, was always pointed to as the best version of that trope, just in terms of its handling of the power dynamic and awareness of that. And Claire Kent is actually a different pen name for Noelle Adams, who is a contemporary romance author that I really like. Another thing I like about Escorted in comparison to The Kiss Quotient, even though I think I'd ultimately agree that this is probably a little bit better, I do think it's interesting that it has quite a different backstory of why the man involved became a sex worker, and I think kind of a less like sympathetic version of that than what happens in here. I mean, basically in this one, he's a sex worker because his mom is sick and he's trying to pay her medical bills, like pretty sympathetic, and it's a more complicated story for the guy in Escorted. But anyway, if you liked that trope and you were looking for another good version that is aware of power dynamic issues and seeks to address it in the text, I would recommend Escorted. And then finally, one last one is that a big title last year was The 7.5 Deaths of Evelyn Hardcastle by Stuart Turton. And if you liked that, I definitely think you should try The Rook by Daniel O'Malley. And this is now getting a little bit of hype, I think, because they've got a TV adaptation, which I definitely need to try to check out. But basically, the reason I would compare these is that both of these have a lot of purposeful disorientation of the reader, because both of them have a premise where somebody wakes up in somebody else's body and has to figure out what the heck is going on. Both of them are mystery plots. Both of them are like kind of magic-y and kind of like you're not totally sure if it's magic, is it science, like how did this even happen? And like I said, a lot of just sort of purposeful disorientation on the part of the author to the reader. I would say that I think that this is a much better book, basically, in terms of the ability of the author to pull that trick off. But I still think that this is really good. This was 4 stars. I give this 5 stars. And if you liked this one last year, definitely give The Rook a try, because I think it has some of the same kind of plot beats to it. Alrighty, and that will do it for my If You Like This, Read That book edition, because I did also, in the course of coming up with this list, think of a lot of author read-alikes. So like, if you like this author, you should try this author. So I'm definitely going to come out with a sequel at some point here in the next few weeks where I talk about some of those ones where I think like, hey, just in general, if you like kind of what this author does, you'd probably like what this author does. So look for that. But yeah, definitely let me know what you think of any of these. If you've read both of them, if you think that that's a good recommendation, or if you kind of struggle to see the comparison I was making, let me know if you think of any other read-alike titles for some of the ones I mentioned in here. And yeah, I think that that will do it. So if you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, follow me on the social medias if you are so inclined. I have all of that information listed in the description box below, and I think that that will do it. I hope you guys are having an absolutely lovely day, and I will just talk to you soon. Bye!